Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about the brute force attack. To learn more about brute force attacks, how they are performed, what kinds of attacks exist, and how to prevent them, keep watching. So let's get started. A brute force attack is a method of trying to guess passwords, login credentials, encryption keys, hidden web pages and content, and gain unauthorized access to data, systems or networks. It is a trial and error approach that seeks to exhaust all possible combinations to arrive at the correct password. The name of this attack is derived from its method. There is no complex strategy behind it. Instead, it is a forceful attempt at arriving at the correct result, which may utilize millions of combinations. Though it is an old attack type and can take a long to yield results, it is still popular. In preparation for a more profound attack, brute force can be used when other vulnerabilities cannot be exploited as part of a larger attack scenario, such as in the drone attack or during the surveillance and infiltration phases. A successful brute force attack can result in attackers hijacking an account or system, injecting malware, stealing or corrupting data, redirecting traffic from a website, etc. Ideally, brute force attacks seek to exploit identification and authentication vulnerabilities and failures. One of the vulnerabilities listed in the OWASP Top 10 2021 edition. When used to guess passwords, a brute force attack can be very efficient against short or commonly used passwords, but it will slow down and run into difficulties when dealing with longer ones. The longer a password is, the greater the resources and time required to guess it. The convenience of a brute force attack is a set it and forget it approach, requiring minimal attention. Since some tool is usually used, once it is launched, the attack is carried out automatically and either works or doesn't. In particular, if no account lockout policy locks login attempts after a certain number of unsuccessful tries, this creates the necessary conditions for the attack to run. The primary way this attack is executed is via GET or POST requests. In its simplest form, when trying to crack credentials, an application or script bot is launched that attempts every possible combination of numbers, letters, and characters to guess a password. In some instances, lists of commonly used credentials or leaked credentials may be used to increase the chance of success, since a lot of passwords are weak and similar. One way that attackers equip themselves to perform such an attack is via the dark web. Brute force malware kits are frequently sold on the dark web and include the tools required to launch an attack and lists of leaked credentials. In addition, bot kits can also be purchased on the dark web. These provide access to botnets, hijacked computers whose processing power is used to launch a brute force attack. Following are the main types of brute force attacks, based on their attack vector and method. Other types of attacks not listed here include mask attacks, permutation attacks, rule-based attacks, etc. Simple brute force attack. This is the most straightforward type of brute force method. It is also known as an exhaustive key search attack. It utilizes tools or scripts that automate the process of guessing a password and makes many consecutive guesses until it arrives at the correct answer. Depending on the computing power of the attacker, they may be able to make thousands of guesses or more per second. This approach pretty easily cracks simple passwords that lack differences in letter cases and symbols. Dictionary attack. A dictionary attack attempts to crack user passwords by utilizing common phrases or words. This may include using words from a dictionary and number combinations, but it frequently also uses lists of leaked credentials, known as credential recycling. This approach may further be developed to check for variations of words that use different lower or uppercase letters, or that substitute letters with special characters, also known as leetspeak. The dictionary attack is more specific and relies on certain phrases being more commonly utilized as passwords, but is limited by the logic provided. For example, it will not attempt unlikely or random combinations. Hybrid brute force attack. A hybrid attack utilizes the simple and dictionary attacks together. The initial approach may be based on external logic, such as the dictionary attack. The possible suggestions will then be modified as is done in the simple attack. All sorts of variations will be tested. For example, it is common for people to use strings of numbers at the end of their passwords, such as 1234, the year of their birth, etc. Using a dictionary approach, a common password will be tested, and many combinations of numbers will be attached at the end and exhausted in all possible ways. Credential stuffing. This tests a known, stolen or leaked combination of username and password from one website on many other websites. It is based on the logic that people sometimes reuse their usernames and passwords. Reverse brute force attack. Typically, attackers start by knowing usernames and trying to guess passwords. In a reverse brute force attack, attackers know passwords and try out different combinations of usernames or account numbers. Password spraying attack. This approach is utilized when account lockout policies are in place, and attackers are limited in the number of attempts they can make. For example, instead of trying out many different combinations of passwords, they will take one password known to be commonly used and try it out on many other accounts. Rainbow table attack. This attack relies on reversing cryptographic hash functions. To crack credentials, attackers will use a pre-computed table or dictionary of plaintext passwords and the hash functions that correspond to them. However, the approach is limited, as it can only be used to guess hash functions of a certain length. Botnet attack. A botnet attack relies on harnessing the power of many machines at once to perform a brute force attack of any kind. By infiltrating and hijacking whole networks of computers, attackers solve the issue of lacking computing power to execute brute force attacks quickly. Moreover, using a botnet helps to hide the attackers further. To protect against brute force attacks, organizations can implement some or all of the following measures. Institute a lockout policy that limits the number of login attempts and locks accounts after several failed attempts. Implement progressive delays and slow down attacks by introducing delays between failed login attempts. Use CAPTCHA because brute force tools cannot perform CAPTCHA tasks, which creates a hurdle for the automated nature of this attack. Institute a strong password policy, reject weak passwords as a principle, and instruct robust and complex passwords and periodic password changes. Close down unused accounts by removing them with high-level permissions as they constitute a severe risk. Use multi-factor authentication since it provides an additional security layer that requires a greater degree of security compromise to be successful. Provide high encryption. The higher the encryption rate, such as 256-bit encryption, the more difficult it is to brute force a password. Randomize password hashes. Hash salting introduces random strings of characters to passwords, making the hash randomized. Hunt threats aggressively, as they can spot attempts at successful brute force attacks. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.